What's up YouTube, it's your boy Mark Dark, and I'm back with another video, and tonight I will be talking about The Chi Season 1 Episode 5 Recap. Let's go, man, let's talk about it. Now the episode starts off with your boy Jake. He's hanging out with Red, and once again, he's trying to prove himself. He's trying to prove himself with his brother, and right now it looks like they're shipping some guns, and your boy Jake decides to take a gun, put it in his pants, runs around the block and take a picture and put it on social media. This dude he's doing too much, and we can see him running from the guy that was chasing him. But Jake is getting into a lot of trouble, and I mentioned this before. It's going to be bad for Jake because he's so eager to prove to his brother that he can handle it, and he's trying to show off. That's his weakness. He's showing off entirely too much, and I think it's going to come back and hunt him in the future episodes. But yeah, we start the episode off with your boy Jake once again doing something very stupid, trying to prove to his brother that he can be a part of the gang. Now we get your boy Brandon. He's hanging with his cousin once again, man. They getting high and just talking shit. Really, I mean, talking shit about what he need to be doing. He tells him he know who killed his brother and all that. And they talk about Jerrica and all this shit. And this whole episode, man, they just kicking it throughout the whole episode. Brandon is still has no place to go. He's not talking to Jerrica. He's not staying with his mother. So all he can do right now is to continue to kick it with his cousin, man. That's all he can do. I mean, and they will get a whole lot of shit cracking in this episode. Trust me. Now, we get to your boy Q, Quentin. He goes back to Sonny's and tells him, like, look, man, we need to get the old crew back. I need the contacts. We need to get the old crew back. Your boy Quentin is trying to take back what's his. He's trying to take it back what's his. And your boy Emmett ended up walking in on him. And he told Emmett, look, you need to go mop or sweep or do something. You need to get up out of here. You know what I'm saying? Your boy Emmett, he still owes Quentin that money. And he better pay him. But I got a feeling that Emmett going to be used later on down the line. I thought it was going to happen this episode, but Quentin, he planted that seed with Emmett, and I'm pretty sure in later on in this series he's going to use it for his advantage. But Emmett needs to watch out because he's going to get himself into a lot of trouble, a whole lot of trouble. And this episode, your boy Emmett does kind of get into some trouble, but I'll talk about that a little bit later. Now, like I said, Quentin, he's trying to get the old crew back. He goes back. He got two of his old buddies right now, and they're trying to think of a master plan pretty much on what they can do to take back the territory and take over once again. This is what they want to do, and this is why Quentin came back. I mean, we all know he's trying to prove something. Now, talking about Emmett, we get back to Emmett. He goes back to the dude that worked at the store, and he said, look, man, what you need me to do? He gave him the J's. You know what I'm saying? Got the J's from dude. And the dude said, look, I need you to drive this van. Go pretty much go pick up a shipment. And Emmett is like, all right. I mean, okay. He does it. He really does it. And you can tell he's nervous because he don't know what he's getting himself into. But like I said earlier, your boy Emmett, he's doing some shit he shouldn't be doing. And it's going to catch up with him eventually. Now we get to your boy Brandon. And his cousin, once again, they get pulled over. They didn't even get to pull out. They smoking weed. You know what I'm saying? They nervous. And it almost ended bad for them. But luckily, the officer gave him a break. And during this scene, his cousin tells Brandon, look, man, you need to go ahead and smash Sarah. You know what I'm saying? You need to smash Sarah. Jerrica, she don't really, you know what I'm saying? You need to make Jerrica want you, pretty much. And Brandon really is like, man, nah, I can't really do it. So anyway, they end up texting Sarah, like, what's up, or whatever. Brandon really don't want to do it. His cousin is kind of peer pressuring him to do it. He don't want to do this at all, you know what I'm saying? He knows Sarah wants him, and we all see that. That's what we think. But Brandon knows it's not right. He knows that Sarah, his boss and Sarah are pretty much husband and wife. So I don't think Brandon really want to get involved in that. And speaking of Jake, like I said earlier, he's flashing way too much. He's, you know what I'm saying, spending $100 beer at the store already that he got from Red earlier. He is not wasting any time at all to flash. And like I said, that's going to be his weakness. And your boy Kevin, his bike is stole by Andrea's cousin. She keeps stalking him, and she stole the bike. So eventually, your boy Kevin is going to go hunting for the missing bike. But like I said, Jake, he needs to calm down. He's too flashy, and is going to come back to hunt him in the future. Now we get back to your boy Emmett. Now Emmett, he goes to the place with the van, and it's kind of scary at first. He don't know what's going on. The shit seems fishy. He's very, you know, fearful. Like, damn, what's going on? I done messed up. I done got myself involved into something I shouldn't have never did. And this is what I'm talking about. Your boy Emmett is just so desperate for money. He's willing to do some stupid shit. And luckily, it don't end bad for him. He gets kind of saved. Now back to Brandon. Your boy Sonny telling him, look, you don't need to be messing with no other chicks. You need to back Jerrica, you know what I'm saying, pretty much back, you know, cry. Come, you know what I'm saying? I want you back. Don't cheat on her. Whatever you do, do not cheat on her. And Brandon takes that, he takes that advice, you know what I'm saying? Like, okay, I'm not gonna screw around. Now a lot of you probably saw this scene already in the preview trailer of how Tracy pretty much said, I don't want to be involved with you, Ronnie. Ronnie got the phone, and you know what I'm saying, she pretty much turned on him and said, you know, I ain't got nothing to do with this. Ronnie said, shit, I got the phone and I did all this shit for you. You know what I'm saying? And look what happened. Tracy's like, I don't have nothing to do with this. I don't want this phone. I don't want nothing to do with you. You trouble. And this is what Ronnie's grandmother told him. She's only using you for something. You know what I'm saying? She don't really want you for real. She's only using you for something, to gain something. So Ronnie finds out the hard way that he cannot be around Tracy. Jake, once again, gets caught up. Now your boy Papa, he dips out. He said, my mama said I ain't allowed around this block. Your boy Jake think he tough, so you see he on the wrong block, and these dudes, like, they ain't having it. They let Kevin go, and they pretty much punk out Jake. They punked him out, and Jake, he's gonna get himself, he messed around, get his ass popped. I'm telling you, he's gonna get popped. He thinking he tough. And these grown men ain't gonna play with him. They gonna shoot you, dude. They're not going to play with you. They will smoke you. And your boy Quentin, he got the whole crew. Now they all looking and spying on Reg in the stash house. They all looking and plotting on what they should do. Now Reg and you know, Trice, they're very aware that they're being spied on. They know this now. They understand that Quentin is spying on them and they're plotting something. So eventually, it's going to be a showdown. I don't know when it's going to happen and how it's going to happen, but these two crews will have a showdown, I believe. Now, Emmett, he gets back with the shipment. He wants to know what it is. Well, apparently, the dude got a boxes of full of cigarettes. You know, he's selling them by singles. You know what I'm saying? Your boy Emmett is like, well, look, I got the shoe game on lock. You just give me some money. We can get some inventory, and we can make a lot of money. So your boy Emmett is trying to hustle, and he kind of doing it in a illegal way. He needs to be careful. But right now, like I said, Emmett right now is, he's going downhill. He's going downhill, and I hope he don't screw up messing with this illegal shit. But he need to leave it alone. He don't really know a dude like this. He can wind up being locked up or getting hurt. And I think one of the two is going to happen in the future. Now, your boy Kevin, man, he get up there to get his bike back, but he let the girl have the bike. You know what I'm saying? She got a kid. Now, I don't know if this kid is hers or whatever, but Kevin kind of felt sorry for her. So he let the girl have the bike. You know what I'm saying? He let her have the bike. And all it's going to do is drag this out, because now she thinks Kevin really likes her. Kevin, I don't know what the dude is doing. I mean, I guess he's doing the right thing, but I really don't really care too much about that storyline, to be honest with you guys. I just wanted to talk about it. But this is the storyline I do want to talk about, and this is what a lot of people have been thinking in the rumors. They're saying that your boy Quentin, he's the real father of Jason. And we see Tracy, she doesn't talk to him. She walks straight away when she sees him. So I'm going to talk about that later this week, about Quentin being Jason's real father. Seems like the rumors may be true. Now, at this block party, because remember, this episode is about a block party. Reg and your boy Quentin, they get into it, and Quentin told him, look, you got your brother right here. You got your brother right here. I will smoke him. You don't want these problems. Like, your brother will get smoked. Your boy Red, he takes that advice and said, You know what? I'm cool. We don't want no drama. You know what I'm saying? Red's like, I ain't scared to die, but Quentin is like, shit, your brother's scared to die. You know what I'm saying? He can get smoked. And Red took that to the heart. So, like I said, a showdown is going to happen between Red, Trice, Quentin. I mean, it's going to be a showdown, and I'm pretty sure it's coming very soon. Now, we get to your boy, Ronnie. Ronnie is, like I said, y'all, he's a walking zombie. He's at the party, the block party. Kevin sees him. Brendan sees him, and he's like, man, I got to confront this dude. So he goes to talk to him. Ronnie confesses once again and said he made a mistake. Somebody told him that Jason was killed by Coogie. You know what I'm saying? He messed up. And your boy Brandon said, yeah, you did mess up. You're going to deal with this for the rest of your life. And he told him, don't mess with Kevin at all. So it seems like as of right now, everything is squashed. Ronnie took the gunshot, got his ass beat. Hopefully they squash it and nothing else happens between this storyline. I hope that goes that way. You know what I'm saying? I don't want nothing else happening. But it seems though for Brandon, it gets worse. Now, Jerrica's at the block party. She's at the block party, and you know, she's kind of like at the kind of funny. You know what I'm saying? She seems kind of happy at first to see Brandon, and everything seems cool at first. You know what I'm saying? You know, his cousin sent that picture of his penis and all that, and she, you know, he told her it was a joke or whatever. But come to find out, your girl, Jerrica, yes, Jerrica, she brought her own date. I don't know who this dude is. He's a friend or whoever he is. It's somebody she's been talking to. Now, the whole thing was, this whole episode, that Brandon should have been the one that brought Sarah to the block party. That's what Brandon's cousin was telling him. Like, you should bring Sarah to the block party to make Jerrica mad. But Brandon didn't really want to do it, for real. He didn't want to. Now, I don't know how good their relationship is. I don't know how long they've been together. But damn, Jerrica, you could not wait to bring somebody else. I think it's wrong of Jerrica to do that. Now, I don't know the time frame of when Coogie got killed or whatever, but for her to sit up there and have the nerve to bring a dude to the block party, and I mean, she said that she was surprised that Brandon was there because he don't like stuff like that. But for her to have the confidence to do that, I think is very disrespectful, regardless of what, if you mad at Brandon or not, I think it's very disrespectful to bring another man there. The dude made a joke like, oh, you the dude that keep calling and whatever. Like, damn, like, really, Jerrica? Come on, man. For real? Now, all this is going to do is make Brandon do something very stupid. He may mess around and probably sleep with Sarah, for real. I mean, I don't really know, but I feel for Brandon, man. I really feel sorry for him because in reality, he don't really want to mess with Sarah. His cousin was kind of peer pressuring him to text her and all that. He was really trying to do the right thing. He really, truly loves Jerrica. And for her to do this, like I said, we don't know her motives or why this dude could be a friend. Regardless, she should never brought this dude there. If he was just a friend or something, I think she should have explained herself better. She said, it's not what you think. That's what she kept saying. It's not what you think. But still, like, why would you bring him there? Like, for real? You need to have a great explanation, in my opinion. A very good one. You know what I'm saying? This dude talking about, oh, you don't want to keep calling. Like, for real? This dude brother just died. And you running your mouth? You know what I'm saying? But Jerrica, I just feel like this was the wrong move for her. Regardless if she think Brandon is not going to be there or not. For her to be mad and get pissed off at him, that's cool. All right. But for her to run off and bring another dude there, that ain't right. You know what I'm saying? Now, I don't think Brandon should have even thought about bringing Sarah there either. But like I said, this man just lost his brother. He's been through a lot, and she still brought this dude around. Like, really? You know what I'm saying? That's messed up. Now, her first mistake was telling her friends about Brandon having a gun in the blood. Now she made another mistake, and that was bringing this dude there, and Brandon was there too. So she didn't care, man. She don't really care. I don't know how good their relationship is and how deep it is, but apparently it's not that deep. If she was so quick to bring another dude there, it can't be that deep to me. But you guys let me know, man, what did you think of this episode? This episode was a solid episode. It was like a pretty much a good vibes, you know. It was a good day in the Shy, pretty much. It wasn't a lot of violence. You heard gunshots at the party, but they continued to have the block party. Overall, solid episode. Next week is the episode I'm ready to see, because now we can finally see what's going to happen between Quentin and Reg and Trice and all them. But for this episode, man, the thing that pissed me off the most was Jerrica. She pissed me off. She pissed me off a lot, man. She tripping, man. She should not never did that. She shouldn't have did that, man, in my opinion. But you guys let me know what you think of the episode. Leave your comments below. I will bring you more of the Shy later this week. And I want to thank you all for the support and all the love. I'm at 15,000 subs. We going strong and we continue to grow each day. But I'm going to get on out of here, man. It's your boy, Mark Dark. I'm out. Peace.
Yeah. Super Bowl goals. I'm at the crib of Puff. He got Kaepernick on the phone. He in a whole different mode. Angel head, 2 a.m. for being whole. Just to show him how I treat the city like my humble abode. Hey, tell me if TD Bank is a...